Welcome back to another edition of DC Film Room's Game Film Analysis. Be sure to like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter at DC Film Room. In today's game film analysis, we'll look at Ronald Leary, number 65, left offensive guard for the Dallas Cowboys. Leary had a very challenging matchup as he had to go up against number 99, J.J. Watt, for the Houston Texans. Alright, now here's the first play of the game. J.J. Watt is going to do a swim move right here and get past Leary and tackle Murray in the backfield. Let's watch the play. He gets past Leary. Leary has an arm on him and he makes the tackle in the backfield. Let's watch it again in full motion. Now that was one fall by Leary, but for the rest of the game, he completely shuts out J.J. Watt. Watch Ronald Leary, our undrafted free agent left guard, take him on man. Let's watch the play. Romo hikes it. Leary takes him on. Watt tries to bull rush him and falls right down. Alright, now that last play really showed Leary's pass block ability versus Watt. And see how he does versus the run. Leary's the left guard right here, and here's Watt. Watch Leary on this run play. He pretty much takes him out of the play. Right before Romo hikes it, let's just point out the guys. There's Leary, left guard, J.J. Watt. He's going to take him, drive him out of the play. Tyron goes this way, blocks. Frederick has him. Murray has his huge space to run in and gain some yardage. Leary takes him out of the play. Not bad for undrafted free agent. Alright, now here's another run block by Ronald Leary. Left guard position, but I had to show this one because this is Murray's fumble. You got to keep your eye on Parnell. I really don't know why he's on the team so far. Someone once told me that he saved a coach's life, which is the reason why he's on the 53-man roster. I know he's versatile and can play both positions, a left and right tackle, blah blah blah, but he's just a waste of size and should have just kept with basketball because he's horrible. Keep your eye on him. Murray gets the ball. Here's Parnell. He's one-on-one with this guy. Leary already took care of his dude. All these guys knocked down, knocked down. Frederick's pushing this guy this way. Now, if Parnell would have just man up and block him seriously, Witten has him, it would have been an easy touchdown almost. Watch what happens. Parnell just can't block anyone, and he's one of the reasons why Murray fumbled. Murray should not have kept the ball so high. Now here's Murray. Tucked in right there. Parnell can't even block this one dude, so Frederick has to come over. Leary's watching from the floor. Now, he's trying to keep his hand down, I guess, to plant himself and keep moving, but he needs to keep two hands on this ball. See, he puts down his left hand to try to, break the fall. But his right arm is way up here, and this guy who was Parnell's, he didn't block him really, so he's going to just knock this ball out. Now, it wasn't all Parnell, but he was definitely a small variable in this fumble. Thank you, Parnell, for taking up a position on the roster. Alright, now here we see Ronald Leary just do a fantastic job picking up the blitzing linebacker in Brian Cushing. Brian Cushing is not going to, show the blitz right just yet until the ball is snapped. Cushing is one of the best linebackers, inside linebackers, of the league. And Leary just does a great job at blocking him. Let's watch the play. Shows the blitz, moves in. Leary picks him up one-on-one. Takes him out of the play. The Texans love moving J.J. Watt on the line of scrimmage. They lined him up mostly at the 5 versus Leary the entire game, but he also got some reps on the left side too. He's going to actually go one-on-one with our rookie, Zach Martin. Travis Frederick actually comes over and helps out too. Doug Free has the rushing outside linebacker on the outside. Leary's the left guard. He's going to take care of this defensive tackle, get his hands on him early, and just use his strength just to push him down to the ground. Let's watch the play and see what happens. Romo hikes it. Watt is on the rookie. Travis Frederick is looking this way when he needs to be looking this way too, because we got two guys blitzing him right through the middle. Murray's going to actually take care of Brian Cushing. He did a great job with that. But the safety is actually free to go get Romo. Leary has this guy on the outside, does just a great job getting his hands on there early and pushing him down to the ground right here. Frederick doesn't pick him up. He double teams Watt for some reason. His safety has a free shot on Romo. Leary brings this guy down to the ground, though. Does a great job of that. Let's watch the play in full motion. All right, Romo's going to hike the ball. Martin gets Watt, and then Leary gets the defensive tackle. Both do a great job, but Travis Frederick moved down to help out Watt when he should have stayed there and blocked that safety who was moving in to get Romo right there. Play kind of made me laugh a little bit. Here's Leary, left guard. He's going to go to the second level, take care of this linebacker, and actually just toss him right down to the ground right around here. And this linebacker tries to scream for a flag and, of course, not get it. It's pretty funny. Snaps the ball. Leary takes him and just tosses him right down. And the linebacker's screaming, "Where's my flag? I don't get a flag." Here's another great block by Ronald Leary. He's lined up left guard. He's going to take care of Watt one-on-one. Tyron actually has this guy on the edge. As soon as the ball snapped, Watt just charges right in. And then Leary with his strength, I mean, Watt tried to do that bull rush all game. And that lower body strength that Leary has just took care of it. And Watt didn't do anything all game. Let's watch the play and see what happens. Watt tries to push this powerful left guard, but with his stance and his anchor, he just takes care of Watt and just pushes him this way. And they actually, these two defenders collide together, and they take themselves out of the play. Collide together, fall over each other. Leary is actually incredibly strong because Watt is a very strong defensive lineman, can play anywhere from defensive end to nose tackle if he wanted to. And Leary just plays around with them. Another example of how the Texans move J.J. Watt down the line of scrimmage. He's lined up on the outside as defensive end, and then Leary has number 93 and just does an incredible block and just stands on top of number 93, taking him out of the play right around here. Romo hikes the ball, and then you can see Leary, the top left of the screen, actually just put his hands on number 93 just to take him out of the play. The ball's way up here, though, but Leary just maybe learned that back in Memphis or in high school. Just put your hands on top of him. You know, at least you take the defensive player out of the play. Watt's lined up right here, 5 technique. On the inside shoulder of Tyron Smith. Leary is just going to take him and just block him out of the play. Hikes the ball. Leary has those hands on him and just uses that anchor strength to just take care of Watt. Alright, not trying to praise Brian Cushing or anything, but he's just a tough, tough linebacker. Ronald Leary is a decent pulling guard. He's going to pull to the right side, weighing around 320 pounds, meeting Brian Cushing head-to-head, and Brian Cushing actually knocks him off his feet. Leary does a decent job of taking him out of the play, but here he is. Brian Cushing hits him. Brian Cushing still takes himself out of the play by doing that. He's a bit over-aggressive as he should have gotten off the block instead of shooting on the inside, but just hits Leary, 320 pounds. Pretty tough linebacker. J.J. Watt's going to shoot this A-gap on the inside, do a swim move on Ronald Leary. Travis Frederick picks it up and just pushes him right down to the ground. Let's watch the play. Swim move, picks it up, pushes him right down to the ground. Alright, now there weren't a lot of plays where Watt actually beat Leary in this game. I know Watt wasn't 100%. He was dealing with the flu around 2 weeks ago and had a thigh injury. He still sports his little arm brace, which is really cute and all. Watch Watt just go, you know, one-on-one with Leary, our undrafted free agent, and just, you know, be taken out of the play. Just a great block by Leary in this pass. Hikes the ball. Tries to do some little swim move. Leary kind of has his arm on the inside of his shoulder pad right there, but his right foot is just a powerful anchor. Like what I said before, just powerful lower body strength and can just really take care of someone big like that with J.J. Watt. He tries to throw his hand up, but doesn't do much at all. Let's watch the play from the start. Hikes the ball. Leary's got him. Alright, watch this play where Leary actually goes down to the second level and blocks out Pro Bowl linebacker Brian Cushing. Leaves a huge hole with the help of Zach Martin for Murray to run in and get about 4 to 5 yards. Leary gets to the second level. There's the rookie Zach Martin. There's Leary, Tyron Smith, block right here. Just a huge hole for Murray to run in. Unfortunately, this guy is left unblocked and comes in there and makes the tackle on Murray. No one blocks 93, but Leary still does a great job of bringing the Pro Bowl linebacker and Brian Cushing out of the play. All right, same play as before. Ronald Leary just gets down in the second level extremely fast, takes care of Brian Cushing, and blocks him out 5 yards out of the play. Great block by Ronald Leary again. Goes to the second level, pushes out Brian Cushing, and then Doug Free bench presses both those players. All right, guys, this is going to be the last clip that I show, but here's Ronald Leary and here's J.J. Watt. This play pretty much summarizes the entire game of how Leary just shuts out an all-pro defensive lineman. Let's watch the play and see what happens. Leary just shoves J.J. Watt right to the ground. Now, for someone like Leary, an undrafted free agent, to just manhandle J.J. Watt, it's not just talent, it's definitely coaching involved too, but if he keeps it up and he keeps on progressing like this, our offensive line will be set for the next 7 to 8 years. I love Zach Martin, the first round draft pick that we just got from Notre Dame. I like Travis Frederick from Wisconsin. Tyron Smith is, of course, Tyron Smith. Doug Free is decent. He could be replaced maybe next year in the third, fourth round. If not, definitely get someone to groom behind him, because Jeremy Parnell is not it, as we saw in that fumble and how he was just horrible at blocking. So I really love Ronald Leary, his strength, his lower body, right foot anchor, that how he can just, prevent that bull rush, especially from a strong guy from J.J. Watt. Like I said, he keeps it up, and our offensive line will be good for the next, 7-8 years. Alright guys, thanks for watching. Make sure to tune in next week as I break down week 6 matchup versus the Seattle Seahawks.